They are the ones that came in October to report that they were behind, they were illegal.
And appealed for completeness, the reports of these waste streams have been tabled before this inquiry. You know that, don't you?
Yes.
In your affidavits before the Constitutional Court, and so this is one of the questions the Constitutional Court is required to address, you did not make any reference to the work of the waste streams.
Yes.
Can you give an explanation why that was the case?
I think I was concentrating on whether I would personally be the one to pay, or it would be the department, or it would be asked to join it.
I'm affects are enough. Ubuti and the quasi cause of which Yini Kabanguti Akfanele court.
I thought that I had actually put on the table sufficient evidence points that pointed to the fact that I would not be the one to have that.
Whether or not you are going to be joined as a party in your personal capacity in those proceedings, did you think it relevant to mention the work streams in that regard?
I think at that time I did not consider it important.
So the question of whether you had to pay the cost out of your own pocket, did it occur to you relevant that you mentioned the work streams and your work?
And umsebenzi wama extreme ngangubona umsebenzi wobusta umsebenzi wama executive.
I did not consider that important. I thought I had made it clear of what my contribution has been, and that the work of the web stream was actually to define the capacity in order to force us to begin to come through.
Let's step back. In one of the meetings, once it was realized that April 1, 2017 was not really achievable, there were discussions about an interim solution involving CPS. Do you remember that?
Yes, I remember that.
What was your immediate reaction to that proposal?
What you were in commit?
The committee was formed.
Elal Father Ama stakeholder.
I don't think I like this flash, it seems to be necessary.
A committee was formed comprising all the various stakeholders in
one paper of 2017. When that suggestion came to the table, what was your response to it?
I was in a dream.
And why was it not implemented? You did understand my question.
maintaining a well?
Mhlazane, ngazi ukuthi sesifakile i-report. Mina ngangiye komunye umhlangano bona ama-executive eye kuscope.
On the day of the report being submitted, I had gone to the same meeting, but the executive had gone to scope.
And uma ngabe bebuya ngingakwazi ukwenzekela kuscope. Mase ngithi kuzolwa biza wonke umuntu khona sizohlalana sikhulumeni i-affidavit.
When we returned, before I even became aware of anything, I was told to write a check. Let us all get together so that we can do our jobs.
Emva kwalokho uzodwa wayese eyasho ukuthi uzwe emhlanganweni ingathi ekuthiwa sesifakile i-affidavit.
It was then that Zoba mentioned to me that she had picked up at the meeting she had attended, as if we had to bring some meeting.
When you told me for that application or that report was sitting with the Constitutional Court?
No, I don't remember. Because at that moment, the acting person there was Mr. Zoba.
So, why has put it put so sharp?
He was well aware that there was going to be a sitting for the matter to be fleshed out.
But where was Cecilia? Cecilia, who's over the affidavit is submitted. But Nami and Rabona get Cecilia in the way of the result of the man who
did. But allegedly, it was also for him. And we spoke about that you became aware of the first time that the application would take place.
And you wanted it to be gone?
Yeah.
Yes.
Because
I did not exactly know what was in it.
Umama uza futhi ukuthi kuthiwani kuyona, nabanye babengazi ukuthi kuthiwani.
And when I inquired around, I found that there were other people also. We did not know what it was, how it was working.
Okay, let's go to something else. It was in December when the option of using the South African Post Office resurfaced, am I right? As a means by which digital funds could be paid.
On the 1st of April, yes.
How did the discussion arise about the post office as a possibility?
Is Pagani Solesi Savela, Ngoba Ikomiti Lady Elna Treasury, Social Development, SASA, Reserve Bank, Lishali, La Peruti, Matama Option. So our services. Yes, we have been in the post office.
It was after a committee that comprised, you mentioned the Reserve Bank,
SASA,
Social Development. That joint committee discussed the options, and among them, the post office was also mentioned as a possibility.
And your reaction to that as a viable option was what?
Ngaphambi kokuthi ebiwe kulo mhlangano, sasikade sesihlanganile thina sisodwa saxoxisana. Umbono wami wawuwukuthi vele i-post office siyifakile ohlelweni lethu lokukhokha kabusha amagranti. Kodwa angeke nje ikwazi ukuthi ngo-1 April ithathe over ngoba kumele ilungiselele kakhulu ukuze ikwazi ukuthatha over.
Before that meeting by the joint committee, we had also met on a date, and my personal view had been yes, the post office is one of the options, but I still make clear that as much as it is an option, it did not mean it would be able to simply take over on the 1st of April. Because it did not have all the capacity at that time. So many things had been put in place last week.
You deal in summary with the questions that this inquiry is supposed to address in paragraph 70 of the statement. You'll find that on page 23 of the statement. That's why you summarize it. Let's refresh. The first question that is sought to be answered is that you did seek the appointment of the individuals to lead the West Teams. Your answer to that is yes. And you do indicate in your evidence when they were appointed, am I right?
Yes.
And it is correct in your letter you say they must account to you directly.
Yes.
And you have tabled the full reports or the content of their report to the
Yes.
And you do say that there are it did not occur to you relevant to mention these work streams in your affidavit before the Constitutional Court because only two issues were supposed to be addressed, i.e. why you shouldn't be joined in a personal capacity and two, why you should not be allowed to pay the costs, right? Can I, in conclusion, ask you this? Did you have a somehow a way to frustrate the attainment of SASA being able to pay the social grants itself come on April 2017?
Understand.
Not at all.
Do you somehow intend to have CPS have a life longer than 1 April 2017 in contradiction to what was told to the Constitutional Court?
I did.
Did you interfere with the work of SASA in any way that was designed to help SASA achieve the objective of itself paying those social grants come 1 April 2017?
No, I didn't. And if I did, I'd still be happy for anyone to point out how.
Those are the questions we have for the witness.
Mr. Similarly, copy of the statement I have is not signed, let alone being under oath, is not signed. I don't know if we do have the signed one anyway. The statement from which you'll be reading.
That we will provide a signed statement. The witness did confirm under oath the right and the contents of the right. Will provide a signed statement.
And I had to say that at the beginning. I had that general statement by the witness. And do we then accept that by that statement, this statement, by the witness statement, you have started a general statement? Because of that, can we then comfortably accept that whatever is in this statement which you have been reading, the witness takes it to be under oath?
Do you confirm, Minister, the correctness of the statement, the unsigned statement, to be your account of your evidence, the statement dated 30 November 2017?
Yes.
Yes, I'm not comforted.
Thank you, Dad.
Because I wanted to be clear about the status of this unsigned statement. Now I'm quite sure about the status.
Thank you.
The first of the respondents, who is the first of the respondents? Who are you appearing for, Mr. Martin?
For the Black Sash Trust, the first applicants.
Yes, you are not the respondent.
But
I'm trying to deal with the respondents. Because my approach is that when it comes to cross-examination of the first respondent, I'm willing to have the respondents first to cross-examine because of the too many commonalities between their versions before I bring a counter version into the form. You understand what? So,
thank you, Judge.
Let's go on now with the first of the respondents.
Justin Mepe, as you are aware, my name is Mr. Raja and I represent SASA. The current CEO, who is Ms. Pearl Bang, who appointed by the minister, is acting CEO. The political head of SASA is the minister. Our instructions are presently not to contest this matter, but to be available to the court to be of assistance. We propose that we be permitted to revisit our role apropos this witness, the respective minister, at the end of cross-examination.
So the company, you propose to do what?
To revisit whether we can be of assistance insofar as the evidence is concerned at the end of cross-examination. We would submit that the dispute before you is presently formulated are the two different versions, that of the minister on the one part, and that of the former CEO of the other part, who is represented, and the former Director General of Social Department, Mr. Dengel, who is also represented.
I thought you were a party to proceedings. Unlike Mr. Dengel and Mr. Lukwasa, I thought you were a party to the proceedings.
Well, we were party to the proceedings in this sense. We went to the Constitutional Court to ask for an indulgence. Ordinarily, we would have paid the cost. The other parties came to court, as I understood, they wanted the minister to be held directly responsible for the cost, not the department, or not SASA. That then resulted in the referral to oral evidence based on the different perspectives of the role of the minister of the one part, the former CEO of SASA of the other part, whose version is augmented by Mr. Dengel. I have explained this to my client. I've also explained to them that I would have a conflict in pursuing any other agenda because I've continuously represented SASA with different and respective CEOs, which includes the former CEO who is now represented by Mr. Solomon. So our role here really is simply to give assistance to the inquiry.
Okay, you can take this. Are you done with it?
Yes, you are.
Ms. Bartlander, and who's for the Yeah, too late, that's the problem. Who is for the Trigomanda Nagar?
I am.
Yes. Let me be at first, Mr. Bagley.
Thank you, Judge. I do wish to cross examine this.
I know you want to cross examine, but I want
you're
really ready to do so, but I want to know in relation to what Mr. Carson has said, the order of things.
That's acceptable to us, Judge. We have no objection.
What Mr. Carson has said is acceptable to you.
Yes, you may.
Judge, I have no objection to Mr. Carson reserving his rights.
Yeah. Okay, well, if the parties have no problems with that, we'll deal with that. Except that for now, I am not sure. You use the word cross-examine, the witness. After the people.
Yes, sir.
No, I mean Mr. Kessler. And
so I suggest that I reevaluate Sasa's role apropos this witness after the witness
has been. Sorry, you agree what? Sasa's what?
I roll up role in the matter, and so far as this witness is concerned, it may be necessary to call a witness to assist the commission. Pursuit of the true facts. At this stage, I don't actually see any reason why Sasa should be entering the arena insofar as dealing with the matter.
Let's simplify it. You have no questions.
Yes.
Mr. Butler?
Thank you, Judge.
No, wait a minute. Wait. He's not the only respondent. Who is the other respondent? I want to hear from the first person. I'm not yet convinced that the respondents would put questions after cross examination by them.
I'm first and second respondent.
I beg your pardon?
I represent, I'm sorry, the second and third.
So you're speaking on their behalf or
on their
second. Who is the next one? Who will be the next one? CPS?
Judge, yes, we're the sixth respondent. So I have no question.
All right, thank you. Now I'm clear. Yes, Mr. Barton.
Thank you, Judge. Good afternoon again, Minister. Minister, on the 17th of March, 2017, the Constitutional Court made a judgment in the application about black sash and freedom under law. You will know that. Well, I shall repeat the question. On the 17th of March 2017, the Constitutional Court made a judgment in the application about the black sash and freedom under law.
Yes.
Have you read that judgment?
Yes, I read.
Now, as we know, in November 2015, Sasa informed the court that it would take over the payment of social grants at the end of March 2017. Is that correct?
It is true.
That was late in 2015, November 2015. Would it be correct to say that in 2016, the core focus of SASA was to ensure that grants were paid and to meet the March 2017 deadline?
I do not quite understand the question.
Would it be correct to say that in 2016, the core focus of SASA was to ensure that grants were paid and to meet the March 2017 deadline?
What do you mean by the corporate?
Their main concern and business.
I indlela umbuzo obekwe ngayo angukholi kodwa kusukela ku re-registration kuze kuya kule process yokuthi sizokhokha thina bekade umsebenzi wenziwa kodwa neminye imisebenzi iqhubeka ngoba umsebenzi wakasasa akona kuphela ukhokha kwamagranti.
I cannot claim to understand the question very clearly, but I can mention, yes, that SASA or we, we were focusing yet on asking people to do the payouts in house.
Okunye okubalulekile ukuthi usasa wayevele anomsebenzi owayewubekelwe ukuthi uqale ukwenza i-enrollment.
And certain duties have been laid down for SASA to start with enrollment.
So into engangiyazi ukuthi bayibhekile ngqo indaba ye-enrollment. Then eye-payment ikade i-link noma kade ihlangene namanye ama-process.
Yes, I knew that they were definitely held to ensure that the enrollment takes place. But there were other duties as well.
Minister, I'm asking you a simple question, I hope. Is it correct to say that in 2016, the core focus of SASA was to ensure that grants were made, grants were paid, and to meet the March 2017 deadline? Do you agree with that statement?
Ukuthi umsebenzi owawenziwa usasa ube kwenza nabanye abantu ube ngakwenzi yedwa.
I think I've explained that yes, SASA was doing work, but SASA was not doing things in isolation. There were other entities helping out.
Could the witness please be given the affidavit which he filed at the Constitutional Court in response to the judgment of the 17th of March 2017. It's Item 41, page 541 of the Black Settlement.
Mr. Barton, I didn't actually hear you. Can you just pick up your voice?
I'm not sorry, Judge. I'm asking that the witness be given the affidavit which she filed at the Constitutional Court after the judgment of the 17th of March, which is it. I want to show her something in that affidavit. Could you please go to paragraph, it's a black slash court, black slash trust record.
Please take me to that affidavit, please.
Judge, it's page, it's the affidavit starts at page 541.
541.
The black session.
Thank you.
our pages don't correspond, but either way, I have it now.
Thank you. I'm sorry, this is your page number
547,
is that? 562. Well, that's in the, yes, that's the first page of the affidavit, Judge. That's right. 562 is the first page of the affidavit. Unlike, I'm going to have it, probably. The witness has it, I just need to make sure that you have it, Judge.
Judge, we also received our index a little late. Perhaps it might be useful if you mention the item and the paragraph. Then find us on the page.
Yeah, I think that will help.
Yes, it's paragraph 53. Do you have that, Judge?
Yes.
Thank you, Judge. Now, Minister, I want to read to you what paragraph this can be just identified. This is the affidavit that you filed at the Constitutional Court. Do you see that? Minister, do you see that this is the affidavit you filed at the Constitutional Court? The letter was sent to the acting CEO, Ms. Rama, 4.23 May 2016, to confirm her acting appointment, and that Mr. Matwaza, the then Director General in the Department, was to ratify all major decisions concerning SASA. Now the sentence I want. This was an attempt to ensure that the necessity for short-term acting appointments did not derail SASA from its core focus of ensuring that grants were paid and of meeting the 31st March 2017 deadline. So those are your words,
If you are referring to this, yes.
What you said there was correct. That was their core focus. Is that right?
I said I agree.
Yes. Well, sorry, can I just make sure that we tidy up procedures? The minister. Minister, I think because sometimes the interpreter is not sure whether you are going to use interpretation from English into Isizulu. And all the time, I've noticed that sometimes he waits. He doesn't spontaneously or immediately translate into Isizulu because he's sometimes under the impression that you don't need interpretation. So that caused some bit of confusion. Maybe you should elect whether we should instruct the interpreter. For example, once Mr. Buckland has put up a question, our request to the interpreter would be immediate interpretation. And then you hold back. You don't answer directly to Mr. Buckland. You hold back and wait for the interpreter to interpret. And then you could, of course, elect whether you are going to answer in isiZulu or English. But if we are going to have that kind of seesaw, there'll be problems, and the record may also look quite clumsy. So I think exercise your right as you wish to say to the interpreter, I'm not going to answer to any question that comes in English. I'm going to wait until you interpret that for me. And that is the you are spoiled for choice. You should choose which procedure you want. All right. Now, for now, I assume that you will not answer immediately. You will wait for Mr. Kulu to put it in isiZulu, and then you can choose whether you answer directly in English or in isiZulu, in which case you would have to interpret back to. All right, now we're clear to the things now. Mr. Barton.
violence against women and children, alcohol and substance abuse, violence output.
Just to mention two.
And my program.
And others also include that and youth.
Amaye awabandabadan.
And there are some that involve.
Amaye apatelene poverty. Ngapande wama grant. Woba ama grant akolela abantwana suba ku 1 kuya ku 18 apinde akolela abantu aba above 60. So kuna labantu aba between leyo mnyaka aba poor aba important njengalaba abawu 17 million.
When we take all these programs in perspective, we also need to know that homeless assessment comes to children, we may say from 1 year to 18, and then again from 60 and above. But then there are many in between us that from time to time also need to be evaluated for social crimes because they are mainly poor.
Let me not go around in circles. Can I just put it to you in this thing? You will agree, I'm sure, that if the social grant program fails to operate, 17 million poor South Africans will be without money, which they desperately need every month.
I'll give you an idea, I think. Uma ngabe uhlelo lokukhokhela abantu nemali, abantu abalingene. Abantu abayi-17 million eNingizimu Afrika angeke babe nayo imali. Uyavuma?
Now, I think you know that this part of the case is mainly about whether you have reported fully and frankly and honestly to the Constitutional Court.
Do you agree with that? Now, I think you know that this part of the case is mainly about whether you can you repeat, please?
This part of the case of the litigation is largely about whether you reported fully and frankly and honestly to the Constitution.
Yes, that is what we're talking about.
I want to read to you section 165, subsection 4 of the Constitution.
You will have to repeat that.
Read it slowly.
Section
165, subsection 4.
Lapha sifunda isigaba 165, isigatshana 4, somthetho sisekelo waseNingizimu Afrika.
It says, organs of state,
lapha futhi izingxenye ezikahulumeni,
through legislative and other measures,
ngokuthabela isinyathelo sokushaya imithetho nezinye,
must assist and protect the courts.
Kufanele zisize.
Impartiality, dignity, accessibility, and effectiveness of the courts.
Are you aware
of that obligation of the U.S.
Minister? Yes.
So this part of the case is really about whether you treated the courts with proper respect to ensure their dignity and
effectiveness.
Do you agree?
Mina was la kupapa ukuthi kufanele kube imina engikhokhayo noma sihlangene no government sikhokhe or u government yedwa ofanele ukuthi akhokhe.
As I understand things, we are here on about whether I, in my personal capacity, should pay or the government should pay along with me or just the government.
Now, Ubuti Ngabanga il Kaza El Panele Nina M 71.
And also whether I actually did my part, whether I did my work in doing what happened.
The court, what the Constitutional Court wants to be able to decide is whether you acted in good faith or in bad faith in your reports. Right, now I want to refer to the question of the process of the appointment of the work streams.
Manje ke ngisengihamba ngiyoshola inqubo yokuthi lama work stream emkhakhabusebenzi iyamiswa kanjani.
We know that on the 15th of July 2015, you instructed that work streams be established.
Siyazi ukuthi ngomhlaka 15 kuJulayi wena waphi isiyalo sokuthi lama work stream abe.
Correct.
What year?
15th of July, 2015. So let's take it the 15th of July. You instructed that work streams be established to deal with this.
Yes.
And you decided who would lead the work streams.
Emva kokuthi sibe nomhlangano we-advisory committee yanikeza i-report, sacela bonke ababekade beku-advisory committee ukuthi mabe-available ngoba kunomsebenzi omningi asifuni ukuqala phansi.
Yes, but only after the advisory committee had done its job of advising, and also after we were clearly asked who of them would be able to stay over in order to help with the processes that they performed.
And for memory or institutional memory.
And also to ensure continuity in terms of the institutional memory. Otherwise, we would have to start all over again.
Yes. You decided that these people who you identified would lead the work streams.
No matter who will be born, child.
Yebo, kodwa futhi okubalulekile kubona laba ababezohola amathimba. Kukhona omunye owa-withdrawer esevumile ukuthi uzosebenza. And ngoba sasingafosi abantu ukuthi bahlale basebenze, samyeka and then umsebenzi wakhe sawufaka
Yes, but it must be made clear that people were asked to volunteer. For instance, one person, after initially agreeing to stay on, later turned around and said, no, we would not be able to do so. In which case, then we decided that that which he would be responsible for would be given to someone else.
I'm going to interrupt you, Minister. I'm going to interrupt you. You obviously have the right to answer questions the way you want, but I think it will help a lot if you have to appease a lot. If you just stick yourself to a question, for example, the immediate past question was, as I understood it, you drew from the people who were members of the advisory committee to form, you drew them into the, you brought them into the work streams. That's how I understood the question. The way I understood your evidence, the answer should be yes. And actually, you said, you started off your answer by saying yes. But instead of stopping there, you went on to say, but not all of them. And then you went on to you wanted to explain how some of them did not have it towards them, a question which was not yet asked. Maybe it's better if they say, you see, if you ask me, is your name Bernard? I'll say, yes, my name is Bernard. But I won't want to say, yes, my name is Bernard. You see, it was given by my grandmother and my grandfather and so forth. I just say, my name is Bernard, full stop. If anybody wants to know where I got my name from, it is for them to come with the next question. Where did you get your name? But I'm not going to volunteer and go into giving them that information if they don't ask for it. Because if you go on giving information which they have not asked for it, you may find that you get yourself entangled in some situations. It is their duty, if they want information from you, let them get it out of you. Don't over-volunteer information to them. Let them work hard for the information that they want. Yes. If yes will work, just say yes. If they want more, let them work a little bit harder to get more out of it. Anyway, as I said, the choice is entirely yours, but I'm just telling you from my experience of some 20-something years doing this talk, just how best to answer these questions. Yes, Mr. Bartlett, I interrupted you for a good reason. Thank you.
Minister, you directed that this process must be action with immediate effect.
Yes.
And you said that this panel which you had identified would account directly to you.
Yes.
And you did this, I suggest, because, as you have agreed, you had the primary responsibility to ensure that SASA passed
March 2017. Yes.
And this direction that you gave to the CEO of SASA was an instruction.
This one is okay for us seeing as that you see all Yes.
Yes, she understood it as such. She wrote on that letter to Hatler, please implement this instruction. She understood it as
why found that answer on a better or tell myself a little in your watch what says on which don't yeah.
Yes,
sir,
you agree.
Yes.
Now, I want to go to your statement which you produced for this hearing. Could you go to paragraph 30, please?
If I go between here and Akana, move paragraph 30, what is going to be for CEA or as well?
Paragraph 30.5.
Move paragraph 30.5.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, you have decided who was going to be employed to as the leaders of the West. Now, I want to read to you the first part of paragraph 30.5. You say, fifth, my decision to retain the services of certain members who are on the advisory committee was in no way intended to usurp the authority of SASA over the procurement of those web schemes. You see that? How can that be true when you had told them who to whom to procure?
Social development, who recommend, who need a directive, and all who should be done, who should be on our web stream, our servants in Ganjan.
I need to clarify that I do have some authority as the political head in my capacity as the Minister of Social Development. But I do clarify that for as much as I could give directives and make proposals, I did not give instructions on how the work needed to be done.
I'm not talking about instructions about how the work needs to be done. I'm talking about instructions as to what the outcome of the procurement process.
I think in the procurement, in Amsana Nezindo, as in a green, as in the room to under qualified, I therefore unsettled to Oyeto of Owabu Yakumina was with him, who said, Lava Obakashi.
Well, as far as I understand, for a person to finally qualify for employment, the person has to meet a number of criteria. For instance, after the people were appointed, I am not aware of one person or anyone that came to say, but that one individual who was appointed does not meet these and those.
And I think we're talking past each other.
So
I'm saying to you that you instructed the department or SASA whose services would be procured. And in that way, you did use SASA's authority to use a procurement process.
And we saw you with the Nobody ever complained about that to me.
That's not the question.
No, but two things are why we have
putting together that you did use the function of SASA to decide who will be procured. Do you agree with me?
And you show your booting, I don't see it.
What would have happened if SASA had hired somebody else, had found somebody else, and said, oh, this, we can see this person is better? What would you have said? That's not the question, please. The question is, if SASA had said to you, we know you wanted us to appoint this person, but look, we have found a better person, and that's the person we appoint. What did you say?
This is our mother, good team.
Well,
Mina Angel was a trained Angel, that at San Antonio Drive. Ngoba lokhu azange kuze kwenzeke. So manje angikwazi ukubeka impendulo yami entweni engazange kuze kwenzeke.
Well, I'm not exactly sure how you want me to answer here because I'm only just basing things on how they actually happen. But then to presume what I would have done if there were peace and so on, based not on reality.
If they had appointed someone else, that would have been contrary to your instruction.
Oh, we're getting my mama's death, and I'm going to move it. I'm going to have a little bit of a problem.
What was going
to happen? Well, that is your
view. No, I'm asking you if that's correct. If they had appointed somebody other than the people we directed, that would have been contrary to your instructions.
Yeah, but we could use one more one who's a mean who's born a year or who's a lot of people. And one of the brothers and one of the people who's a man 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 who's a man. Oh, and I cannot agree to that because there was no such thing that happened.
Yes. You issue instructions and people obey them. Whether or not they vote.
So my members will get him over well more people to see a letter. I want to deliver some move and just see. No matter it's a very good one. Government servants know exactly what I want to say.
Sorry, I didn't hear you, Mr. Kuhl. Mr. Kuhl, I know it's in the afternoon after lunch and so on and so forth, but please avoid, particularly towards the end of your sentences, to drop, avoid dropping your voice. Oh, you know, okay. I of all the participants here, I'm the fattest most.
Okay, I will repeat. Sorry, Judge. I was not aware that they I repeat. Government servants, those are the words of the moment. Government servants know government procedures.
Yes. God was put. I'm going to take a machine. What is a salary? What is known as a bent? Baba Sass.
And it must also be noted that I have already mentioned that prior to all this, we had met together, myself including Sasa executive, and we all agreed that this was the way it was going to go.
Minister, are you aware that the National Treasury said that the appointment of the work stream leaders in this process was irregular?
We are not telling you the National Treasury if you get a work from our stream. While we go ever have the National Treasury, we go have
better.
Yes, I am aware.
Is that important to you?
Very
important.
What are you going to do about
it? Who's going to do it? I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it.
Well,
the
talks have already started with the National Treasury, where we were explaining just the kind of pressure we were under in order to ensure that things happen within the short time frame that was allowed.
These appointments were made 2.5 years ago, irregularly.
La Rovante, Bafa, Wablum, Semit, Emnagin, Abba, and Edil, and Emma,
And you have a point.
Sorry, not sure if I can hear you, but I don't think it's a good point.
Otolo, ahí ya le dije, no hay otro que nada.
Is anything being done to rectify the situation?
Poco no hemos entrado, se fue en si güey, y hemos llegado más. O sea, no lo hemos sabido, eso sí. Yes.
What is being done?
Begin a sentence.
Lo un buzo, yo no también puti, o caso, un sentence, o va, bueno, es vaya, se va a fin, te un puti, buen si va a ganar, no me ve. Ufuna, ufegana, ninguna, en general. Y te lo mbuzo una pedruga kahle abasebenzi ngoba ibona abazi kahle ukuthi lolu hlelo olunje lwenziwa kanjani kodwa ngiyazi ukuthi mina sengibile nemihlangano sihamba neyikhulu zana social development nezakasasa hlangana nethu.
Well, I cannot get into the detail. But I think Sasa executives would be in a better position to answer this particular question because they are the ones that know the exact procedures. But yes, action has been taken.
You told the judge earlier today that the reason why you followed this process of not inviting bids was because it was urgent, time was very short. You just repeated that a moment ago.
Not inviting what?
Not inviting other people to participate.
Oh, there, we are not going to be able to do that. We are not going to be able to do that. We are not going to be able to do that. We are not going to be able to do that. We are going to be able to do that.
Yeah,
we should.
Yes, I think so.
Yes,
you said, let me read back to
you
what you said in your evidence. You said that you said the reason there was no open tender was because of the time.
Hotel up on Azana's business is starting, so to say, open tender. No one has to do that.
Yes.
Yes.
I want to show you what the letter which was written by the National Treasury, dated the 5th of May 2017.
Wow. 5th of May. Nintendo.
It's dated 5 May
2017.
It's page 890 of the Black Self Trust paper. 890.
You have to go slowly with me again if you read.
Item 55. Item 55.
For the item 55.
Black Self Trust record.
Do they report here in that session?
8-5-0.
That's in 8-9.
Judge, do you have?
I don't know.
Do you have it, Minister?
We forbid it. Yes.
Now, you'll see, this is a letter from National Treasury to Mr. Magwaza, as acting CEO, dated 5 May
2017.
The second paragraph says the following. National Treasury assessed all documents relating to the appointment of workstream leaders slash suppliers.
The National Treasury, EA, this is our own gamma paper. Of Catalina, the group, Minister, and the Market World Card, and what are all the national books?
The assessment revealed the following non-compliance.
The Google paying of the Mirror of Desert now or Matabar.
I want to show you what the National Treasury said in paragraph 7.
Now, I have a new paragraph 7, you can go for this and I will be the National Treasury.
Let me read paragraph 7.
You can go for the paragraph 7.
There is no evidence that procurement was urgent. Because proposals were received on the 30th of October 2015.
30 October 2015.
A and considered by the Writ of Adjudication Committee on 5 April 2016.
While the what you while you want to have a big adjudication committee on 2016.
What is your answer to that?
Oh, okay, we'll have that.
Here's why we know at the equal civilian on Shannon, etc.
Notwithstanding this letter, we had a meeting.
Do you agree or disagree with the statement in paragraph 7?
Well, for me, I'm not going to pick Sana, Nalama, as we are sure, and we have to say.
Lo umbono, umbono, was a treasure.
This is a view by someone, a treasure.
You said you know better about procurement than treasure.
Namayama, the whole point is what he was that monument, the improper maintenance, what I.
But if one of them had done, he bear for him Sangan, a school in Sana, nine in the treasure.
Well, that might have to be your view, but the truth is, we have had meetings with the treasury, notwithstanding the existence of this one.
Do you disagree with what he said in paragraph 7?
We are Pixan and I don't know sure enough.
If you don't want to
own a balance, you don't want to come on, what let me say that speak? That is what happens sometimes with the words that if you're spoken to them, I wanted you to know.
Yes.
Oh, sorry.
Well, I'll write you up here and find that. Give me that meet again, Mr. Patrick.
Page 890, Judge.
890.
I'm sorry, we have to fix up the judge's
papers. Okay, I think that the response was that is the view of the person that wrote the letter.
But that's not my question. My question is, do you disagree with the statement of paragraph 7?
I think we're not going to go ahead and go over those of our people. We have to make an idea, we don't have to get an idea. I'm going to need to add. I think what I've said I won't change.
You haven't
answered
the question.
What about the norm?
I know that it is the opinion of Mr. Sangani. I'm asking you if you disagree with what he says in paragraph 7.
And who goes, I would you have Melan and only a pizza and another form? I don't know. I don't know.
Chitangani.
We have made an anomia pizza and I know what we have actually. We have a good one.
Mbono one, because not Salandela, I'm a processes way to I funny.
Well, it's just his view because we, as far as we are concerned, we follow all the auditing process.
So I just want to yes or a no.
Depending on what
you you're saying that you disagree with the opinion expressed by Treasury in paragraph 7.
No, 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 no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no. Well, my response is, I will not say either yes.
So you will not tell the judge whether you disagree, whether you agree or disagree with paragraph 7. Is that right?
No, 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 I will not say either yes or no. Paragraph 7.
Pendula yonke lento, kungadinga ukuthi nathi sihlale phansi, sibhale phansi, siphendule lento le eshuba.
It would take a long response on our part to just responding on this item. That is why we have had to have meetings.
Minister, I don't want to waste time.
I'm going to ask you, Mr. Sosan, for that stuff.
Are you saying will not tell the judge, including the constitutional court, whether you agree or disagree with what Treasury said in protocol.
So, my mama, who's put in there, who will judge who last days, the whole thing, who said that, and the constitutional court, who you have to do it.
Yeah, pick.
I just.
Disagree with paragraph 7.
Pohiksana no paragraph 7.
We feel the sun and the spirit, Salina.
I am against the spirit of the law.
I'm talking about paragraph 7. Do you disagree with paragraph 7?
Ni kuluma lapa na donge o fadero. I am against the spirit of the letter.
What? I'm talking not about the letter, I'm talking about paragraph 7, Minister. I'll give you a last opportunity to answer the question. Do you agree or disagree, or refuse to say that you disagree or disagree with what is said in paragraph 7?
I already said that I am against.
What is wrong about paragraph 7?
You go to open a shy for as a
matter of fact. What is in paragraph 7 that is incorrect?
You go to open a name of Baloe.
From AMA officials as it process the proper and I'm from the numbers me in the but a is reading as a judge in the
look I clearly when the judge I won't be there. I think the best is for all the people involved here to respond because they are the ones that know what processes were followed, what procedures were followed in procuring. I don't want to be the thing to happen.
I want to
repeat
the
question.
I respond that in my teams, AI Balwe, on 15 June 2016.
The letter was written on the 15th of June 2016.
He responds, Yakona, in 5 May 2017.
And the response to it is the 5th of May 2017.
Yes,
ma'am. We
give you another. Logo Biat has
Because a letter written as early as 2016 was responded to only many, many, many months later. And it's not because of any kind of content for the government.
No, Minister, as I understand the question, it's in response to your statement that you did certain things because the matter was urgent. Am I correct, Mr.
Yes, sir.
Now, the purpose of 7 was to say, reading paragraph 7 of the letter to you, was to bring your attention to a view which was held by somebody else from the Treasury. Is it Treasury?
just a question.
This person from Treasury says, no, the minister is not right when she says there was no time in the medical surgery. Now, this paragraph 7 says there is no evidence that the medical surgery. Now, Mr. Bartlett wants to know whether you agree with that person or you don't agree with that person.
Ngoba ibhalwe nini ngomhlaka 15 June 2016 kufanele siqale ukukhokha ngomhlaka 1 April 2017 kodwa impendulo sithola ngomhlaka 5 May 2017.
Yes, that may be the interpreted answer for me, please.
Look, I've already sort of said, and I'm going to say it again. We had a deadline to pay by the year, and the letter was written way ahead of time. But the response comes after the fact, in May.
So therefore you disagree with the letter?
Kube khona abakwazi ukuyikhipha kuyo yonke lento.
Yes,
lokho kukhonjiswa yini ukuthi i-response ize ifika sedlule nento esiyijahile leyo response ithi hhayi nangajahanga nayo i-response ngokwayo yayingajahanga.
Look, we wrote a letter because the situation was urgent, and we had a very short timeline, and it is clear from the letter that the letter was written for the purpose of giving some people the chance, or shall I say, the opportunity to pull out of the commitment. The whole thing was written very early, but the response came long after the fact, which shows that you are not addressing the concern of the government.
I appreciate that elaboration, Mr. Kuhn, but I thought before the elaboration, the basic answer was, I disagree. I disagree because, et cetera, et cetera. The letter was written long after, and so forth. But I thought the basic answer is, I disagree with that.
Yes, I may have elaborated, but the minister did say also.
Yes, I just wanted to. I don't want the basic answer to be lost in the elaboration.
Yes.
So the basic answer is, she disagrees with herself when it says there is no evidence that the procurement was agent. She disagrees with it. For whatever reason, she disagrees with it. Right. But what I want to know, even if Mr. Bartlett were not to ask that, I want to know whether, I'm looking at the second level of that answer. They say it was not agent because proposals were received on 8th October 2015. And considered by the Adjudication Committee on 5 April 2016. Is that correct?
Kuyiqiniso ukuthi iyiphakamiso zokuthi kuqashwe abantu laba zavela ngo-2015 kodwa bathatha isikhathi ukuthi sizobekwa phambili kwale thimba elihlolayo ukufaneleka nokungafaneleki. Sekwenza ngonyaka olandelayo.
Are you on the same wavelength with me, Mr. Kuhn?
I think
so. You have a copy of the letter?
No, I don't.
Because you are not on the same wavelength.
How?
If my minimum Zulu knowledge of the language serves me well, you don't seem to be on the same wavelength.
But okay, I will not argue, but I think I really did did communicate, and I'm not the only one understanding your English.
Look at the second leg of paragraph, sir. They say, not only they say there was no evidence, but they say they give the reason. They say because proposals were received on 13 October 2015 and considered by the adjudication committee on 5 April 2016.
I didn't mention this.
You did?
Yes.
Okay, maybe as I said.
Yes, I
definitely I'm occupying yes. the most posted position in the
yes, I definitely
did. Committee hearing. Right.
Yes, okay.
Now, put that to the witness,
please.
All I want to know is that information correct? That the proposals were received on 13 October 2015 and then considered on 5 April 2016. All I want to know.
Good judge, you can office of what the team. General Babutua is in Haramus of Science in 2015. We can use a year which you know for that means our company education committee to move. And what did they care? What 2016? That if this was within local shore, won't have a lot of time.
In the Balayan, the process, yeah, in a mapping looking high. What were in what mean they are a Balay man? If Balay and speak human in where it's good. In the end, put a bullet when you were a I'm a terms of reference. If we were to mom big evaluation a committee, no uny, no uny. In Bobabon Global Air is in Rehamba, Ibuya, Ihamba, Ibuya. So, la, I cut this one alone.
Okay. It is not exactly true, as much as it may seem to be so, because this lacks the clarification that although the process was happening, it had many hiccups that made it go very slow. So it's not like everything was happening smoothly and the proposals came now and action was taken only much later. Things were happening and just took long because of all the problems along the way.
And Dutch, maybe in Tepitangu, you very well want to say, the witness is saying it is not a complete story. It's not saying that it is not true.
Thank you. Mr. Bakuta, I don't know whether you have reached a convenient point where no, that we should attend. We should talk about the gym.
Yes, Judge, I am about to deal with the related matter, but it is more a separate and in the light of the place of which we're living at the moment, that may with respect be advisable to the chair now. Because I don't think it will happen. I don't think I'll be able to deal with it. It's related, it's not entirely the topic, but I think it might be best to adjourn now.
Yeah, we may we all assume we'll stop it for a problem. But we may have to talk about being from tomorrow. Today I understand it's the first day, everybody imagined we'll stop it for a problem. But we may have to think carefully whether we, depending on the progress we make, whether we can afford all the time to stop it. Maybe even starting at 9 o'clock.
Yeah.
Rather 9 o'clock. Yeah. Are we able to start at 9 o'clock in the morning tomorrow? Anyway, the first day is always difficult and tedious. So we're all tired now, I'm sure. let us stop here and start tomorrow refreshed at 9 o'clock. Thank you.
I'm sure they've cut, I'm sure. Keep at it, Mugilin.